Hey folks, Quillithine here, and welcome to another episode of Let's Play City Skylines Snowfall. It looks like someone riding in the snow at this point, you know, with all these lines. So I've been thinking about this little traffic backup that's happening here, and I think it actually would be a win for us to connect Cord Street here to whatever street in Vassal Squares, because I think all the traffic that would be going here would still go straight through the intersection, but some of the traffic that would be going here would make the right turn early, and I think that would result in a better division of traffic. Adding intersections blindly, willy-nilly, often hurts traffic more than it helps, but I think this one here will actually be a win for us. We'll have to monitor it pretty carefully. We could also do things with one-way streets and things like that, obviously, but I think overall, this is going to improve the situation. It's not going to instantly change things because a lot of these cars already had their route in mind, but new vehicles that will spawn should do a better job of using multiple lanes to get things done. We'll see. I think these chunks of road are long enough that having an intersection here isn't going to interfere with the flow too badly at all. Those vehicles stopping at these stores don't help things, but overall, I think we're going to burn off just enough traffic from this intersection. And it doesn't take much. Doing something like just eliminating 5% of the cars from over here often will improve the flow so much that the traffic jam just clears itself up. Because it's just like, it's just about bringing it below critical mass. But it can take sometimes, well, in-game here, you know, several days or weeks before the change really starts to manifest itself. I mean, there's still a slowdown here. But ultimately, I think we're going to go and trim this down a fair bit, and I think it will help. So we're going to go and revisit that relatively soon. There's still a huge backlog of cars over here, you can see. This is all a result, mostly of this corner being quite poor. This might lead to something like this, where we get a bit of a death wave because ambulances and then hearses were stuck in traffic. So we'll have to keep an eye on that, but we're going to revisit that a little bit later. Meanwhile, let's do one more pass. Power's good. Heating is a little bit at its high end, and the incinerator, we are not keeping up with that either. This is going to be a great time for us to put in a recycling plant, and specifically I want a large recycling plant. It's very expensive, but it should come with a lot of vehicles, 25 garbage trucks, doesn't pollute, it does have noise pollution, which is the only downside, but we could have it maybe somewhere like here. It's really not going to affect many houses. We can always replace one of these with a park or something like that. It's going to give us a lot more trash collection and won't pollute this area. And I mean, I like the idea of recycling. Who doesn't like the idea of recycling? I mean, come on. So we're going to do that. It's not, you know, for the money, it doesn't process garbage as quickly as incinerators, and incinerators give us electricity and everything, but recycling feels good. So we're going to get a bunch of vehicles that come out there because I think, I mean, especially with the distances involved and the fact that all our garbage processing was over here, every now and again there was a bit of a garbage backlog, and I think we would have maybe hit a critical mass in terms of garbage relatively soon as well. Population's still going up. Income's really great right now. If as we expand and add more services, it can dip quite quickly, but for now we're okay. Oh, it's nice to see some people walking over here. One thing I can do as well is put in the city policy of... Ooh, extra insulation for the houses. Higher maintenance cost and construction cost. Yeah, because we get less tax income from our houses, but we need less power. Ban all electricity for heat. No, that's fine. You know what? We could do free public transit. It does cost a lot of money. Where's the... Oh, encourage biking, despite the snow. There you go. Try and encourage as many bikes as possible. No loud noises at night. Leisure specialized area will close for the night. Yeah, that's one thing I haven't done, is done the leisure areas, but let's just use some generic things for now. What, are you waiting for a bus? There's not a bus stop here. There's a bus stop. No, that's not a bus stop. Okay, no, this might be a bus. What the hell? What are you doing? I'm actually quite confused. Are you guys just gonna stand here forever? Alright, whatever. Yeah, these streets are relatively quiet. And hopefully we have enough walking paths and bike paths so that people are going to be able to use that. Buses. 30 passengers, okay, so this is full. Still some more people waiting for buses. Hopefully it's different buses. They're not just overly full. 30 of 30. Wow, yeah. Now, these bus lines might be too long. Are you complaining about heat? Oh, yeah, you are. And we did remember seeing that. I'm going to go and put down another geothermal heating plant. And it has to be connected. There you go. So now we're going to have way too much. Well, this only adds 80, actually. It's not quite as extreme. But that does make sure we're good. Power, still good. That's good. Garbage. Our incinerator status is still not sufficient. I'm pretty sure the recycling counts as incineration, so we are still falling behind there, which is not great. And the landfill is about to fill up, but it might start to catch up, depending on the backlog. Garbage production. Yeah, the production is higher than the incineration capacity. This is only adding 72,000 per week. Yeah, these recycling centers really don't produce a whole lot. Let's compare it to the incinerator. That's the large advanced one. The regular incinerator. Regular incinerator produces, about two-thirds of the large recycling center? For less than a third of the cost, plus produces power for us. And then the large advanced one doesn't do a lot of pollution, which is good. And produces 136,000 per week. So we might go ahead and just save up for that. I do want to expand to a new area. Well, filling this area here too would be nice, because it looks like we've got a lot of capacity for that. I've already built the ring road. We should be able to handle some of this, especially if we get little intersection stuff going on over here. Again, we might just make a diamond interchange for now. I guess I could go and do that now. It basically will do nothing. But that's okay. It won't hurt us either. Just make sure that these are long enough. When you're doing a diamond interchange in particular, make sure that your on and off ramps are pretty long, because they will get backlogged. And the longer something is, the better it sort of processes. Our intersection over here has cleared up completely. Potentially there were other factors involved. But yeah, I think that just took just enough pressure off this intersection that now things are flowing well. And that's it. Just, again, sometimes all it takes is 5% less traffic and it will clear up. But you usually have to wait to see a response there. So I think I'm quite happy about that. Okay, all the traffic going here should be mostly local. I suppose some of it will go all the way here. But the Grumpy Forever, most of the people should be coming in from the other highway interchange over here. So I think we're going to be okay. And I am leery about adding just too much in this area, because we could very easily overwhelm our roads, especially with these very lightweight diamond interchanges. These are not made to handle a whole lot of traffic. They're really not very good at that. Even this interchange here actually isn't too bad, because there's no weaving. That's true. It's actually not a bad design. That's, of course, the one that's built in here. So that shouldn't be the source of the backlog. Population continues to go up. Money continues to go up. We got the ships that come in here. Oh, I thought I could click on the ship. Yeah, there we go. 100% loaded. 32 on delivery, but which makes sense, because these are mostly not here to deliver goods. They're mostly here to take goods away. And then we get this problem. So this is always a thing. In a theory, building train stations and cargo stations reduces traffic, because all this industrial trucking doesn't have to go all the way out to the highway. But the problem is, it does tend to backlog here pretty aggressively. And that sucks. And part of the issue is you can't change what this road is, which is always a bit annoying. I mean, I could double up on this road, but everyone's just going to be in one lane anyway to make the corner. What could help is, I suppose, if this was one way. Because they would actually use two lanes over here, because some people would go right and some people would go left. It looks like most people are going in the one direction. But also simplify getting cars in and out of here. I guess that's probably a good idea. Add bus lanes here. Bike lanes. I don't think people do much in the way of, this is one way, right? One way, which way? Not that way. That way is the way I want it. Well, I'll probably have to go and do everything. So you can't change this bit, but everything else is going to be one way, so it's sort of going to enforce a direction over there. And there we go, and that's going in the correct direction. So that will help, especially here. Especially if people are actually making left turns, it will help a lot, because they'll use both lanes over here. But this always causes such a major traffic problem. Train stations are exactly the same way. Huge amounts of traffic going in and out. I think the one way will help a fair bit, but like, just look at the vehicles coming out of this thing. Now, some of it is backlogged because they couldn't get out earlier, and that can literally happen. Turns out there's like 100 vehicles in here waiting to get out. Making it a one-way really helps, especially you want to make sure you get the one-way the right way, because you can see here they come in there and they leave there. I don't know if that's inverted if you get left-hand drive, but you really want to pay attention to the direction that cars come in and out of this thing and make sure that your one-way is set up in such a way that your vehicles going in don't have to pass in front of the outdoor. Like if we were going the opposite direction, because everything going out would want to go out to the right and then would get in the way, especially in a one-way. Anyway, just better this way. But again, the left-hand, right-hand drive thing, you want to pay attention because it does make a bit of a difference. And there's a bit of a backlog. This won't resolve itself until a bunch of the old backlog is gone. We can't tell anything, although it is clearly flowing out a hell of a lot better than it was. There's still a bit of a problem heading in, but that will also be flowing a lot better in general too. And I think there's still some cars a bit confused about directionality. You're still seeing a few U-turns here and there. But I think we've improved a fair bit now, so hopefully, cross our fingers. And we are using both lanes. I think a lot of people are in the right lane because they're going here and maybe going out or maybe going into the center of the Zurin 2 industrial concern. Oh, backlog to get into this area. I wonder if we should maybe add another way in. Concerned, especially turning this into a four-way might be a little concerning. But, I mean, what else is this going to change? And really, adding a connection here, how's that going to be any better than this connection? I don't think that's going to encourage more traffic there. Well, maybe. Actually, what I'm wondering is if we increase this road and then connect it up over here. If that might be one way to minimize the pressure on this intersection a bit. Because this intersection is always going to get a fair bit of pressure from vehicles being delivered at the cargo harbor and wanting to leave. And this might move some of the traffic people going into the industrial concern neighborhood out of here to over here. I think it would be a win. The downside is we do have to move this oil power plant. For consistency, yeah, I'm going to use this style. Cross our fingers that we don't just make things worse. And in any case, we won't be able to get immediate feedback about this because it's going to take weeks of game time for these traffic patterns to switch. Although, this has improved a lot. Look, this backlog is almost completely gone. We have fixed the situation over here. That's a for sure. And honestly, the rest of it might just get fixed by virtue of this. Doing this may be unnecessary. And more intersections can often cause problems, but I think that this will take some pressure off there. And again, bring it below that critical mass where everything just starts to flow perfectly fine relatively quickly. So we'll see. Bit of fire there, that's not brutal. Oh, do you not have water connection? Or no, we just literally don't have enough water being created. Yeah. We will need more sewage, so I will go and build another one of these, which does give us a little bit of water, but it's not going to be enough. I'm also going to build a water intake. I'm going to make sure to space these out a little bit so that we don't end up in the situation where we drop the water level in one little area too much. You probably aren't getting power. Nope. Some of these bodies water. Now, this seems big enough that it's probably okay. But some, especially a little river that doesn't have a lot of water flow, you can drain it in a freakish way. In fact, I'm pretty sure this has gone down a little bit too. We're going to have to grab some water in a little bit more of a distributed area going forward, but for now we're okay. Power? Good. Water? Good. Garbage capacity? Right. Insufficient. What is this? Solar Civic Amenity Site. It is a recycling center. This is a mod. It's always like, is it balanced? It's really cheap to build, processes 24,000 a week with no pollution. So it only produces a third of what this one does. This one does 72,000. This one produces 24,000. So it's a third, but for dramatically less cost, it technically produces a tiny bit of power, but hardly any. I'm going to build one, just because it'll be nice to have variety, but it seems a little OP considered this one. They're just both mod buildings, and that's one of the things that always happens with mods. Sometimes it's the quality of life is awesome, and it's less about, oh yeah, you do have a lot of noise pollution though. I guess we'll build it down here. Sometimes quality of life is good. Like, I like these, and honestly, I think they're realistic, and, you know, it mostly is just there to avoid brown poop water. makes the game a little bit easier because you don't have to worry about polluted water flowing back into these things. But it's not that much. And honestly, I'm not sure like the cost ratio is there. But this is quite cool, actually. I love the way this looks. Ah, that's great. And it gives us some more garbage trucks in this general area. Lessens the load a bit. Incinerator status is still nowhere where it needs to be. I think we are still going to build a advanced incineration plant. And I'm going to go ahead, I think, and build it. How are we doing, industry? I think we are going to build another industrial area. Maybe on the outside of this ring here. It would be a little easier to get the train. It's very far from the cargo shipping, but it could at least get some train stuff. Let's actually start with the train stuff. I like that idea. So first of all, you're going to have to buy this so we can reach it. In fact, I should just like buy all the tiles now or something. I don't know. Buy this at least because there's a little bit of spit of land that is annoying. These are getting a little bit expensive, but there we go. A little bit left over there, but let's not worry about that quite yet. So we could build both a passenger train. Oh, we haven't done trams yet. We have trams going on this outer ring. That might be a really good idea. Now, I wonder what that would do, because right now, we do have the bus line. I don't think there's a six-lane version of it. Okay, so we keep the trams off this big ring road. It might not be a bad idea to get a bus line going on this ring road right now. It's a long one. And I don't think it's useful right now, but it will be. I guess one of the things is we might want to put down our intersections first before we put down all the bus stops over here. Okay, that's fine. So, our train stations then. So the passenger train, I don't know, could bring tourists in, but really, like, the passenger train system really kicks in when you have multiple train stations and you set up train routes for your people, which I guess we can do, especially if I'm deciding to build a town over here, which we can, right? I can reach those tiles. I'm going to spend a bunch of money now. Oh, and there's even more. So yeah, that's going to be fine. So we can have these two little sub-towns connected by train service. And I think that would be a swell idea. So building a passenger train station right now won't really do a whole lot for us because it's only going to be there maybe to bring in some tourists. And honestly, we're not going to bring in a whole lot of tourists. But let's do that. And then get an industrial one over here. And then our train track. So this is going to be the sort of driving train track. You don't want your stations... It's a little further away than it needed to be. You don't want your stations to actually be on the driving tracks because it will stop the traffic that wants to go by. This is actually not great. I guess it's fine. You know what I can do? Let's go up and over... That's connected the way I want. Yep, that goes over that way. And yeah, you don't want your passenger trains and your cargo trains to get in each other's way. Nor do we want your trains that are going to a station to interrupt the flow of trains that are just trying to get by. So I've got a lot of space here for my train lines. Way more sort of use than I want. But again, I'm going for a sort of low density build, so I think it's okay. And then... we go up. Over. Come on. What if I do this? Can we get over? Oh, I had it a second. There we are. Building elevated over here, which is more expensive. You want to make sure that these gaps here are big enough that at least a full train can fit through. Otherwise, again, you'll have some pretty serious problems. So that's good enough. I mean, ideally, we don't want this to be a dead end, but for now, it's fine that it is because they can connect up to here going in either direction. I don't know if there's another separate rail connection. It's nice when they have multiple rail connections to the outside world. And yeah, definitely happening because there's an exit that way and also another exit that way. And it seems like every connection to the edge of the map actually has a different source of traffic leading in and out. So you get more bang for your buck if there's more of those connections. These pipes are very expensive, but I think it is worth... We don't have any money. I'll have to wait a little bit longer. I could just run water out here. I suppose you could just run off electricity for heating for now, and we can upgrade the pipes later on. Up a little bit. So you can go over and connect in over there. Okay, you've got that. Then yeah, we'll run the much, much cheaper water pipes. 20 per cell as opposed to 100 per cell. So 1/5 the cost. It was snapping it for a second there. There we are. And then bring this over. 40. That should give you water. There, water and power. And some trains may start to deliver goods over here. This is a million miles away from any industrial area, but we'll have one soon. Now, I should really make use of the fact that the waterfront property does actually have the higher land value for residential stuff. But it still feels like with these tracks here, I kind of want the industrial area to be there. On the other hand, it would be easier if we could get right off this. I don't know. Let's let this run for a little bit. We'll accrue a little bit of money and see what happens. How's our traffic going on over here? You're complaining about garbage, which is... There we go. There's a garbage truck nearby. Not a surprise, though, because it is hard to get in here with the traffic the way it is. It might be a little bit rough. There's, once again, a backflow over here, so we haven't quite resolved this outflow of deliveries, which is a real shame. Now, where are you guys going? Are you delivering to commercial things? Where the hell are you going? You're trying to get there. You have to go here, 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 come all the way around to get there. Well, yeah, okay. But a lot of you guys are not going to be like that. And you're going there. And you're taking this corner to do that, which doesn't actually make me all that happy. Although I guess it doesn't matter that much. And we can't resolve this with public transit. I mean, these are all commercial vehicles and industrial vehicles. There's one personal transportation here. But yeah, these are not people driving to and from work as a general rule. Yeah, even that. So, public transit does not fix anything over here. It is all industrial. And it's because, look at the ships! Just coming in one after... Can I, like... I would love if I could cut this down in half. Listen, cargo harbor. I appreciate your enthusiasm, but could you maybe chill the F out? I suppose what I could do is I could just build another cargo harbor. It's a bit tricky, though, because there was actually a limited amount of places where it could connect. I could build one over here, which might alleviate, we'd have to buy a tile, might alleviate the pressure of, like, commercial vehicles that are trying to deliver commercial goods to our commercial buildings over here. How many times can I say commercial in one go? That might be alleviated by building another cargo harbor here. But really, it's the fact that one cargo harbor is working this entire industrial area, and that there's really not a way I can improve that unless we build it across the way here and provide, you know, a bridge across. And that might actually be the solution, especially since we know over here we've got, I believe that's minerals. Oops. Yeah, that is ore. So, that would be a nice little place to build new industry. Now, I don't think this traffic here is actually causing a problem. It's not... we're still growing, we're still making money. I don't have to stress about this. It's not pretty. Doesn't make me happy. But I don't have to stress about it. In fact, we're still growing as is. I don't necessarily have to do much. Wow, look at how many people are doing things over here, too. It's mostly commercial vehicles. Well, maybe that'll take a little bit of pressure off there. Look at the frickin' boats! Oh my god. Just nuts. Yeah, that's amazing how much stuff is happening here. I suspect that there's really, yeah, no passengers happening now. It could bring in tourism if we had touristy stuff in our city, which we don't have set up right now. Tourism is still kind of borked. So I don't know if we're going to make any efforts that way. Again, small towns, how much tourism do you really have? But the cargo, like, this is insane. How much cargo is being worked here? Now, this cutting across here may be a problem later on. If there starts to be more traffic on this road, but we'll see how it goes. We'll see indeed. I really don't want to do too much. I like to see how this, like, this is working well, though. Just a ridiculous amount of stuff being processed here. Take a look at this train. 100% full. Stuff we're shipping out. 100% full. Bet you this one is too. Yep. Going to Las Rico. Building this may have taken pressure off the cargo stuff. Will be interesting to see in a few weeks exactly what that looks like. Yeah, this is why the diamond interchanges are bad. People are coming off the highway and then wanting to make a left there. Really not good. So we can develop a better interchange here later to resolve that. The other thing too, though, is I think if we sort of developed our six-lane avenue over here and then had an on-off ramp from the highway into the inside, so south from here, I actually think that would do really good things for any traffic pattern that happened down here, especially going forward. I think we are going to need another highway interchange over here to service the southern half, to service this inner block. And I think that would be a great way to develop things. So let's go ahead. I mean, I suppose I could avoid bolting than that. But no, it's fine. Actually, I will move a little further here, a little further away from the actual interchange, which has the bonus of avoiding that. Same thing here, just a little further away, like so. And then, I really want things to flow out of here very well. But my concern is things coming out of here that want to go over here that'll just take up more traffic. There we go. And then just some two lanes, or four lanes. That cord across this way, and won't really be used for a shortcut. Well, they might. Let me go and build the interchange first. We'll spend some extra money, who cares? It's only government, it's only taxpayer money. How do we want things to come in and out over here? I actually might just make some one-ways. Or a highway connection so that we don't build anything on it. And it will give us the maximum speed. That might not be too bad, especially the sheltered ones. So we can have out and then in. Now, are these making traffic lighted stops? Not on this side. There's a traffic here. That is pretty short in between, and that makes me unhappy. There we go. Just a little bit more. We can actually put a little bit of building in here if we want. Maybe a park. That'd look quite lovely, I think. Now, I guess there's no reason, since I'm already building this, not to do something like that. That looks stupid. Why don't you line up better? We're not being space efficient here. But that's okay. So not perfect. I think that's as close as we're going to be able to get here. So that's fine. And then from the other side, I'll just pop off so that... How do we avoid weaving? So this is the one out. That Feels lumpier than it should be over here, doesn't it? I could probably smooth this out. Just maybe, like, elevating this as quickly as possible and then connecting up. That'd probably end up looking pretty smooth. Still a little wonky, but yeah. And then from here, you go up a level till you cross, then drop down. Can we get you to drop down and sneak under that? Nope. Well, I'm sure I can, actually. Come off here. Go up. And around. And then down. And through there. And over there. So we're using a lot of space for this. But it's going to go fast. And the only question is whether these intersections are a problem, and I don't think they should be. This is the only one with a light. This being a little bit short isn't necessarily ideal, but it's fine, because there's no light here. There could be some people coming here and want to make a left turn that could slow out the traffic a bit, but I don't think so, especially if there's not really anything built in between these two. And we can put a park, and technically parks do get a little bit of traffic, but hardly any to talk about. So it should be okay. So then the question becomes, where do I put the industry and where do I put new housing? I could line up some industry around here. It might be a little close to some of the housing, but not that much. Especially if I get a little bit of a commercial buffer zone. Do I want to just paint? I think that should be okay. Alright, do that. We have to start building some offices at some point too. I'm going to go with low density commercial here. Some offices. You need fairly educated people to work here. This might be a great place to put the university, though. Actually, let's go ahead and build a strip of offices here. Oh, things are lighting up. How lovely. A little bit at a time. I didn't realize they lit up a little bit at a time, which streetlights do, because they're all just built on individual sensors. Now, you don't usually see blocks of them lighting up at a time, but individual ones will start popping in and out. So now what I want to try to do is avoid a situation where people are using this as a shortcut to get anywhere. And curvy lines do let you generally avoid that. I'll go ahead and make this a four-way intersection. Four-way intersections are a little bit more complex and slow than a T1. On the other hand, it does mean you have fewer intersections at that point, which is good. That's industry. I might not build anything there, other than maybe parks, but I could have a little walk, which would be a pretty good idea, I think. Here, then yeah, build a little connection between them. I don't think they'll see much cars, but you know, just to say. There we are. And this is going to be low density residential. I guess I'll bulk do this, but then I'm going to remove a whole lot of it. Like all this near the industry, and on this main road, which is going to be loud. Back that up. This could potentially, this should probably be a commercial area. I don't think there's going to be that much pollution spillover, especially if I put a lot of trees down. But we can just eliminate the question in the first place by doing this, and certainly we'll have the demand for it. That's going to be fine. And then here, it's going to be really nice to get a little pedestrian path There we go. Through there. And certainly another one over here. I don't know how many people are going to use it. We actually might be able to fit one in. No, it's still de-zoned, but oh well. And some like that. There we are. And maybe off over here too. Some great ways to enable people to walk to different areas. I suspect we'll have a bus running on the outside here, so it's probably a great idea if we had more than one. Plus people might be able to walk to work to their offices. That is a very wobbly path, but you know what? It's a fun one to walk or bike. Same thing over here. There we go. Give people an ability to get to that outer ring. All right, so before my population freaks out, we are gonna have to get some pipes over here. And you know what? We're gonna have to, oh, we have money. We can upgrade all this to heating pipes because they're gonna need it as well. I'm gonna go and put a cut in this video here. When we come back though, we'll continue to develop that neighborhood. And we'll have finished this entire little circle, and I really do want to develop something out over here to try to break things up, but it was just such an ideal spot, especially with the rail. It would have been a waste to not develop it. Thanks for watching, folks. See you next time.